Hello, friends. The Procreate 5.4 update is finally here, which means we have 180 new brushes to play with. Let's take a look. Now, before updating, it's always recommended that you spend some time backing up your artwork. I usually just airdrop my files to my Mac, where I have them all sorted and organized. Now, the update went smoothly. I didn't have any problems at all, but it's always best to back up your files just in case anything goes wrong. I've already updated the app on this main iPad, but I will walk you through the update on my older iPad just so you can see the process. Now, you'll probably just get an automatic app update. Procreate is rolling out the update slowly this week. But if you'd like to get your hands on it right now, you can go to the Procreate site. And if you scroll down to all new brushes, tap here to learn more. And if you scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page, you can update today. So go ahead and tap that. For me, the update took about 2 or 3 minutes. You'll see a window pop up to let you know that the brushes are being upgraded, and this will take another couple minutes. Okay, when that's all done, you'll get another pop-up asking where you want to save your brushes. You can either save them to iCloud or locally on your iPad. So I've chosen iCloud, and those brushes are now saved and your update is ready. Okay, I'm back on my main iPad now, and I just wanted to show you where the brushes are saved if you chose to save them to iCloud. If you tap on Files, then go to iCloud Drive, you'll see a folder that says Procreate Brushes, and here's where the brush library folders will show up. Now you can see here, you've got the Procreate library and the Classic library, and if you tap there, you'll see all of the different sets separated by folders, and within each of those folders are all the individual brushes. Now here's why they're two different libraries. If we go back to Procreate, if you open up the brush library, you'll see that there are actually two libraries listed. So you've got the Classic library, which is the old version. So in here, you'll have all of those classic sets from the older version of Procreate, but you'll also find any custom brushes that you downloaded and saved, any saved folders, like if you created a favorites folder, that will still be available to you. Any brushes that you've added before, they're still there. Now, when I initially did the download on this iPad, when I opened up the Classic library, it was scrolled all the way to the bottom, and I had a mini heart attack because I was like, oh my gosh, where are all of my brushes? But just if that happens, just scroll up to the top. You'll see that they're all there. Now, to switch back and forth between libraries, you can use this little down arrow here and then tap back to libraries. And then tap on the next library you want to open up. Same again, go back to libraries. Or you can use hand gestures. So you can spread to open up a library and then pinch to close it. In this main libraries window, you can see there's a plus sign here, so you can add new libraries. So if you tap the plus sign, you can say create a new library, give it a name. So for example, if you wanted to, you can create a library for just your favorite brushes. And you'll see a new library pop open here. And you can add multiple sets within that library. So instead of having a long list of favorites to scroll through like I did with my old favorites folder, I now have all of my favorite sketching brushes grouped together in one set, all of my favorite inking brushes, painting brushes, and so on. Oh, and by the way, you now have the option to change the icon for your brush sets. So if you tap on a set, this window will pop up and you see here an option that says customize icon. Tap that and you'll see several icons to choose from. If you prefer to use an emoji as your icon, you can do that as well. So tap on a set and instead you'll tap rename and you'll just add the emoji to the name. So just choose whichever emoji you want to use, tap apply, and you'll see your emoji show up instead of an icon. Now, as you're organizing your libraries, you have the flexibility to move or copy brushes from one library to another. So since I'm setting up a new favorites library, I can go back to the Classic library where my favorites folder was and select a few brushes to drop into the new set that I'm creating. So to do that, you just tap, hold, and move a brush till it pops out like this. And then to select multiple, you can just tap on additional brushes so that you can select them all at once. Then close that library, open up the library and the set that you want to drop these in, and then just drop them into that new set. Now, just remember that when you're adding brushes to your favorites folder or any other set or library that you've created, it's always best to duplicate the brush and add that duplicate to your new set so that the original remains intact. So let's say I want to add one of these brand new brushes to my favorites. So instead of just picking it up and dropping it over there, what I'm gonna do first is swipe left to duplicate it. And actually in the old version of Procreate, a number 1 would show up next to a duplicated brush, but for whatever reason, a number 2 shows up in this version, and you know that that's the duplicate. So then I can drag this one and drop it into my new sketching set in my new favorites library. Now, one thing I noticed is if you tap on a brush and you go to the About This Brush section of the Brush Studio, in the older version of Procreate, you could tap the name here and edit that name, but for whatever reason, that's no longer an option. I'm not sure if that's a glitch or if the renaming feature has been moved somewhere else in the Brush Studio. I'll have to look into that. Now, as I was organizing, I also added a new library just for custom brushes. So in this library, I have all of the custom brush sets that I've purchased over the years, stamp brushes that I've made for my various workshops. So I'm keeping all custom brushes grouped together in this library just so that they're easier to find. And when you have multiple libraries like this, you can just drag them into whatever position you want them to be in. So as you can see, we now have a lot more options for organizing our brushes. And because we have so many new brushes and multiple libraries, one of the things that is really helpful with this new update is the search option. So if you just pull down, you'll see that we now have a search bar. And you can search by name. So if you're looking for a specific brush, you'll find it here. Or you can search by type. So if I want to find all the marker brushes, I can type marker in the search bar, and the search results will show me all the brushes in all libraries that have the word marker in the name. And it will also show any brush sets with that search term. Now you'll also notice that there is a recent section for each library. So if you're in the classic library, it will have its own recent brushes section. If you are in the Procreate library, same here. So any brush that you recently used in that library will show up in its own recent section. So if you're someone who likes to play around with creating custom brushes, there are several new features here as well. As you know, I focus more on drawing with the brushes than making brushes, so I'm sure there are other tech gurus out there who can walk you through all of the details of the Brush Studio. Now, this is the part that I am the most excited about. There are 18 new sets in this updated brush library, and in each set, there are 10 new brushes. So we have 180 new brushes to play with. And I will definitely be sharing complete brush review videos for many of these new brushes so we can get a feel for how they behave. But for now, let's just take a quick peek at the new brush sets. So we have some really great options in the pencil set. Some are smoother than others. Some are more grainy than others. So I'm really excited to try a couple of sketches with these in an upcoming video. Then we've got the pen set. Let's see, let's give this one a quick scribble test. Oh my gosh, these are so smooth and so beautiful. It's gonna be hard for me not to want to draw a whole piece with each of these. Okay, let me focus. So in the inks set, we've got brushes like Shearwater, Nowhere Else, Swift. These names are kind of funny. Wapping? I'm sure I'm going to mispronounce quite a lot of these, so forgive me, Procreate. But lots of options in the inks section. And then we've got a whole collection of markers. Let's try Yala. Ooh, look at that. Well, that's fun. I'm really excited about this pastels set. It's taking me back to high school, early college days where I was obsessed with oil pastels. So they've got so many great options here. and really great texture. The other set that I'm really excited to experiment with is oils. Now, I have zero experience with traditional oil paint, but these brushes are just so yummy and interesting looking. So I really can't wait to explore those a little more. Then we've got a paints section with lots of great options here as well. Let's just give this one a quick try. I'm also happy to see that there are a lot more gouache options as well. And just with a quick test, these are already miles ahead of the original gouache brush. I am also so happy to see an entire set of watercolor brushes. And thankfully, these are also a massive improvement over the watercolor brush in the original brush library. So these should be a lot of fun to play with. There's an entire set of charcoal brushes with great texture. And then there's a set called Basics. And some of the brushes in here actually remind me of some of the classic brushes. So this one kind of reminds me of the noise brush. And this one's interesting. This actually kind of makes me think of the monoline brush, but with pressure sensitivity. Then there's an entire set of lettering brushes, including this cool brush with a built-in inline feature, basically. Then there's a comics section with a couple interesting texture brushes, like this cool half-tone brush with a taper on it. Then in the design set, there are a couple of interesting brushes in here too. Some patterns, and there's also a dotted line brush, which could be fun to play with. Then if you like yummy textures, there's the grunge section, which has several really great texture options. Then under street art, you've got cool brushes like this one, Cooney, which looks like spray paint. In the digital set, another group of interesting kind of experimental brushes, like this one, for example, which kind of moves a little bit as you're drawing with it. And then the final set is the creative set, which also has several interesting texture brushes as well. I am really excited to explore these new brushes with you as I continue with my brush review series. I will probably choose brushes to test at random, but if there's a particular set or a particular brush you want to see me experiment with, let me know in the comments. If you'd like to check out my previous brush review videos, there's a link to the playlist in the description. Also, if you enjoyed this video, I'd love if you'd give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!